This is my first time experiencing something like this, and I honestly don't know if I knew what to expect.
So it was really hard to visualize kind of what conditions would be like and what the situation would be like here.
At the end of the day, we want every child in the community to thrive, complete school.
This is my second time here. I've been so impressed.
This is very, very personal and very emotional for me. I am African and I grew up on the land of Africa.
You don't know what you don't know till you see it.
And I got an opportunity to meet him at his home with his family. That was really, really profound.
The women that are literally carrying, you know, 4 feet, 5 feet, 6 feet of things on their heads for kilometers to get water from one location to another. So it was, it was my way of trying to show homage to these women.
We're about to go to visit a community that has where we built a early childhood development center. Really excited. I've seen a number of early ECD centers. It's a great place to see kids and to see them learning in their own environment. So come with us.
Right now I am in northern Ghana near Tamale with the board members of Children Believe visiting various projects that Children Believe has been involved with. I'm very moved by the impact that the work of Children Believe has had on the lives of communities here. Children Believe doubles its efforts, doubles its resources, doubles its reach, so that because this is such a good thing that I've witnessed here, it needs to be multiplied. More need to be reached with this effort. So that is my message to Canadians. Let's double our efforts and let's make this happen so that children can have hope as I have witnessed today in this community.
I'm very pleased to be here and to watch the launch of this exciting program that is going to change the lives of all the children that we see in front of us.
We opened a school for a community a couple of days ago. You know, what a welcome. I mean, just that would be, you know, would have been my first experience kind of coming into a community, you know, community similar to this one. People were just so excited to, I guess, be hospitable and be thankful for kind of the support that we've provided. And it was such a great thing to see kind of the kids running into the school for the first time, this new facility, new school, with some new supplies. You know, we had brought, you know, a few school supplies and some soccer balls and other things for the children, and so excited to receive these things.
I was knowing we were going to go visit some communities, some children. I was very excited about that, but I don't think I was prepared for how overwhelming it was and how emotional it has been.
Thank you. I am currently in Sukaya, a village that we have a number of programs in, have been here for, I think, 17 years. You know, the fact that they have water in this village is transformative, something that we take very granted in the global north. It has the joy of that experience of the funds coming in and the supporters providing, whether it's cash or whether it's gift in kind, and you're able to deliver what you can to transform the lives of these communities.
In this community, Children Believe has made enormous strides in providing water, and that has to be the basis for anything. You don't have water, you can't have the medical center that's here, you can't have the schools that are here, you can't, how do you function without sustainable water sources?
13, right? 13.
Oh, longer?
Yes.
Who's been here the longest?
We were at a community earlier today and they have a clinic, and you know, we had a building and they had all of these mothers with their babies sitting there waiting for the clinic and to go through treatment and monitoring, etc. And I was thinking about the two motorcycles that we contributed, which was absolutely fantastic. I mean, it's critical to understand how important basic transportation is, because then that makes the nurse mobile, right? And so the nurse can actually go out from that center into smaller communities.
When I personally went into one of the medical facilities, it surprised me how little we need in order to get something done well, but also how much more we need to do. It's not about what am I doing for Canada, it's what am I doing for my fellow man. It's not just about what you do in your backyard, because you don't learn. Because I'm in a different backyard right now, and I've learned things that unless I was here and seeing and touching and listening to the stories, I would never understand.
Children Believe is providing hope and a future to children, but it is also making a change across regions by creating a movement in communities across the country.
It's just been an amazing experience that I feel so grateful and honored to be able to be a part of this. Yeah.
You know, the world is a very, very mobile place now, and you know, we should all be thinking about it that way, and respecting the fact that we as Canadians have had a series of opportunities that has put us where we are today, where we can make a difference in these communities, where getting work is relatively easy, where getting education is relatively easy. You know, thank the stork that put you in Canada, because you know, he gave you a real gift when you started. And I think we owe it to these communities to allow these children to live and dream fearlessly.